Hey everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com, trying out a new brick-based system that should be compatible with other brands we've seen before. This is a series called Ionix, and it is created by Spin Master, the same company that makes all the Air Hogs RC vehicles and air-powered planes and gliders and stuff, lots of stuff they make. And Ionix is the name of the new brand they came up with. And this series here is called Tenkai Knights. If you want to find out more about the whole background of the Tenkai Knights story, you can check that out at tenkaiknights.com. It's actually not a very cool story. It's really old and obvious and thin, not very deep. Basically, you've got this main bad guy who's like the super overlord of everything evil in the entire Tenkai Knights universe, and he used to be a good guy, but he was really just kind of greedy, and he was jealous of the attention that the other good guys got, so he decided to become a super evil overlord. It's really weak storytelling, but I wanted to try this thing out anyway as a toys series, because they have a new concept that they've brought to brick-based building, the idea of bricks that actually transform. So I'm gonna go ahead and open this up and let you take a look at the parts as they come out of the box. This one right here has the main bad guy, Vilius, and it also has two good guys, Tributon and Kutor. Let's go ahead and check out what we get in this box. All right, so three figures, three bags. I'm gonna start with this one right here, which I believe is Tributon. Your stars of the show. This is the main transforming block here, and here are some of the other parts. See some pretty familiar looking pieces. Got some transparent pieces in there, that's pretty cool. This one is painted. This is the headpiece, also painted. See more of that once this is assembled, but I want to really focus in on this piece right here, because that is your transforming block. So that's kind of a big deal. You know, they've actually done something new. Let's see how this works, first of all. This opens up. See how these are turning down? Those are gonna become the legs down here. You can clearly already see that you've got arms coming out to the side here. Let's see what happens here with these shoulders. Shoulders are coming out. All right, so that's basically it right there. Oh, all the joints have ball joints in them, it looks like. Ball joint there, so this can be rotated. And this is supposed to be locked down when it's in transformed mode, but you still have a ball joint there, so you can still rotate the shoulder independent of the arm. There's no joint inside of the arm, but still allows you to reach across a little bit. And I like that rotation, and you've also got ball joints down here, although there's a little bit limited range of motion down at the base, but it's not too bad. Ha! Huh, that flips down. Didn't even realize that. I was looking at the wrong side. Cool, okay, so that's kind of the base for what you're gonna see for print if you don't put anything on the front of this. And that's basically what the head looks like underneath, and that can be rotated since it's on just a cylindrical center piece. So I'm gonna go ahead and build this up and see, actually I'll build up all three real quick and see what they look like when they're done. There are all three figures from this set, Tributon, Kutor, and the vile Vilius. And I think they look kind of cool, you know, for being little minifigures. They have their own style for sure. I really appreciate that. I appreciate the originality. I think that the design of that main transforming minifigure block works out well, although honestly, there aren't a whole lot of things that you can do. It's really intended to transform between being a bipedal, you know, humanoid style skeleton on which things get attached and a brick. And it's really just supposed to go between those two things. It's not going to transform directly into a plane or an animal or anything like that. It's really just that they start out in brick form to begin with. So I'm just giving you some looks at these guys from different angles, just so you can see exactly what they look like when they are assembled according to the instructions. Couple of issues here. Biggest thing is with the figure in the middle, Kutor. He can't stand up, so let's go ahead and start with him. He doesn't stand up on his own using his weapon, so check out his weapon. His weapon is, well, the way that it's kind of shoulder mounted there, looks like this is going to be an energy ranged weapon, but he's got a couple of blades at the end of it, so I'm sure that he can also do direct damage, hand-to-hand combat damage there. You have different ways of holding this, though. That's really smart. You can hold this up like so, like he's just holding a staff. Very smart. And they also have this additional, I don't know if you want to, maybe, let's see. Yeah, there you go. That works. You can see he's got a blade on the other end. So both ends can be used for attacking. Looks like he can also hold on upside down like so, as well as right side up. So, you know, good range there. But over on this side, he's got a shield, and together they just stand out away from his body, and he's not able to stand up. No matter what, he's going to fall down. So I'll try to lean him back a little bit farther, get that center of gravity a little bit closer. There we go. So if you lean him way, way back, comically far, then he can actually stand up on his own. He still wants to fall forward, but just barely stands up. It's too bad because it's a cool looking figure, especially when you look at it from the front. I'm going to take these accessories off. That helmet is very nice. I like that helmet a lot. And the print on the front, not too shabby. Especially just like the helmet, that's really well done. When you take the helmet off though, that's weak. My personal opinion here, you know, I don't like that. I understand that it had to be small and flat in order to fit in to the whole transforming brick thing, but I like the fact that he's got the helmet on, he can still turn his head. So some things about this are cool, some things about this to me aren't. Let's go ahead and move on to a different figure. Let's move on to this guy here. So this is Tributon. He is able to stand up on his own because he's got wings on the back. This whole assembly back here adds some weight to the back, some mass, and it helps them to balance. So that works out a lot better. I think that all of these figures should have something on the back, and I'll show you that they actually do give you some additional parts. I like his shield. Like I said, it's got a little bit of paint on these parts here, and he's got several different paint applications on the head. You take that helmet off, again, weak, not something you even want to look at, but leave the helmet on. Looks pretty cool. And then he's got a crossbow weapon over here, clearly, which can actually be used two ways. The main thing, I think you would just use it this way. You can either use it like a crossbow, or you can set it up like a bow. I think it's intended to be more of a crossbow though. But these shields, so with this guy, I'll talk about the shields on these characters. It's held on with a handle. You can see how that's attached there. The way that the hands are set up, or the way that the arms actually are set up, you can rotate this around. You can move it away from the body. You can move it across the body. Well, a little bit. It's not holding on there too well, but you can kind of move it in front of the body like so, but you're definitely limited in your range of motion. That's pretty good there, crossing across like so. But you can't bring it in close to the face or anything like that. There's just you would need an additional joint, and that's just not there, but it's okay. Let's move on to the last guy, Vilius. This is your main villain for the entire series, and he's probably the best looking overall on the whole out of these three in this one set, I think. Bad thing with this one, unfortunately, one of the joints, the shoulder joint, the inner shoulder joint here, is really loose, so he doesn't really like to hold up his weapon exactly where I want to put it. So a little bit of miss on the consistency of the quality of the parts there. That's really unfortunate. But I like this different kind of color they used here. Different color red. It's kind of a desaturated rose color for this transparent color for his spear here, or kind of a trident. And he's got another weapon he uses over here. I'm assuming that this one would be able to actually shoot out blasts. Probably both of them would be able to. I really like the helmet, the fact that it's got these two kind of spires or horns coming up high. His face detail, the actual face shape in there isn't the best looking, but I like these wings on the back. That is a good choice there. Also adds a little bit of weight to the back of him, so he is able to stand up on his own, no problem. Even putting this weapon out in front of him. I wasn't really able to turn the head as much as I wanted to because it's getting some interference from the back here, but that's kind of the thing that I wanted to do, is just have both hands on the spear. Works out okay, not all that great, but as long as you put that one weapon down, again, he's still able to balance, so works out. Now here's a cool deal, extra parts. Each figure came with a set of extra parts. The intention is that you use all the extra parts towards what's called RoboFusion, where you combine the extra parts from different characters along with those characters themselves, converting them back into their brick forms to create larger things. As of the time of this video, on the Tenkai Knights website, there are two different RoboFusion creations that are shown. One is they both appear to be spaceships, and you just basically are supposed to add these things together. Now, it's the typical gimmick that toy companies do when doing this kind of stuff. You have to buy more sets in order to get the extra pieces, the specific pieces. So for this one, fortunately, there is one other action pack of three other characters that will allow you to finish one RoboFusion creation. I didn't look up the secondary one, but basically these parts are not intended to be used with the figures as they are right now. But if you want to be creative, why not use some of these pieces with the characters that you have, with the figures that you have? So look at how much cooler he looks now just by adding those couple of things on there. Those are really good pieces to have. Put them right there on the shoulder. Perfect. All right, let's see if I can do that with the other figures too. So here's Kutor. He's now dual wielding, and he's got these panes on the front of his shoulders that help to stabilize him in flight, because he now has a rocket pack on, or a jet pack kind of thing. How about that? Just using the parts that were included with his character. Of course, you can mix and match stuff, parts from different characters, because they're all compatible. Vilius here gets a triple powered weapon, which I'm assuming is also going to give him a little bit of stability in flight, and he can use it for air-to-air combat because he too gets a jetpack. You can see the two little outlets down there, and they're even in red. Just combining all the weapon parts together, and he can still balance even though he's got all this weight on him, so I think that works out pretty cool too. So, summing up my very first experience with the Spin Master Ionix Tenkai Knights minifigures, they're interesting, they're different, they definitely bring in some new concepts, some new building styles, and they give you a fair number of parts here. This was a $17 or $18 set at Toys R Us to get all three here, so you're spending almost $6 each for these little figures. Compare that to kind of the industry standard as of today in the United States for minifigures from other brands. Don't have as much that they can do, but they're usually about $3 a piece. So you are paying the price for all this extra stuff that you can do with them. Whether the value will work out long term will depend upon what else they bring into the series. As of the time of this video, only a handful of sets were available at my local store. I'm sure that more sets will become available very soon. And you can see the full initial product launch and list of products on their website. The whole transforming brick thing feels to me like more of a gimmick than anything, because they really didn't need to transform. They're really not doing that much. The transforming method that they use, and really what they use them for officially, is just to get them back into brick form. So you can take an entire minifig skeleton and turn it into just a regular 2x4x1 brick to use when building up these RoboFusion combination models. They could have just included a 4x2x1 brick as one of the spares, one of the extra pieces, and it would be a very cheap piece. and it would accomplish the same thing that all the transforming thing does. I think that gimmick will get old, and they have to use different transforming bricks to represent or create different types of characters. So they've got a big one, they've got an animal one, they've got a minifig one, and they'll probably do more. So they're really not adding that much value by having that. I like some of the different colors that they use. The helmets overall, I like the helmets. I don't like the heads underneath. Definitely some issues with range of motion and how you can pose them. There aren't all that many different things you can do for posing the arms. Most of the time you're just gonna have the arms straight out. Ooh, just knocked that guy down. Straight out in front, just to have enough room to hold on to things. And heads don't really turn left to right very well. You have to pick up the head that's inside of there, lift it up, turn it, try to put the helmet back on, hope that you don't have anything that's gonna be interfering on the back, stuff that's attached onto the back. And I could already see, just from my very first set, already having a part that doesn't fit in there quite so well tends to indicate that there will be more little quality issues like that. I won't say that that is certain just yet, but it's a kind of an unfortunate start. I would hope to get everything just working as expected here. So overall, I'm kind of neutral on these thus far. The whole Tenkai Knights theme, the whole product series with all the videos that they're creating for it online and stuff, I think it's really overhyped, unnecessarily so, and they just have a lot of really loud talking people from Southern California pretending to be Japanese styled robots, and I think it's a little bit overdone. I don't think they really have come up to the level of excitement in the product itself that you can actually buy that is indicated by the videos and the voiceover acting that they do. So there we go. Those are my thoughts on these so far. Please let me know, and let especially other viewers know, what your thoughts are on this series based on what you knew before, what you've seen before, and then based on what you've seen here in this video or other videos of these actual products. What do you think of some of their strong points? What do you think of their weak points? Do you think that it's worth 17, 18 bucks to get these three minifigures here? Just share your thoughts. I'm really interested to see what other folks think. Right now, I am not all that interested in continuing on with the theme, but if there's a whole lot of interest out there from a whole lot of different people, I may continue to buy more of these sets. So your feedback is going to be really, really important. And please just be honest about your feedback. Just what you think about these products. So thank you for watching. Thank you for sharing this first time experience for me of checking out the Ionix Tenkai Knights items. And you can find more stuff that I've done in the past for other brands, and also stay on top of updates as they become available on my website at JANGBRiCKS.com. So I hope to see you there, and I hope you'll come back for more videos soon. Bye for now.